Matata.
What a
bottom nerd here, y'all.
And Woody.
Woody and Buzz. Don't forget Buzz.
To infinity and beyond.
Episode 61. Today, we are here to talk about some recent releases that Disney has put up on Disney Plus. You all know the premises of these movies. Toy Story 4, Aladdin, and The Lion King. But we're going to do something a little bit different because we're going to compare and contrast. And we're going to rate which was better, the cartoon version or the live action movie. And then we're just going to briefly touch on Toy Story 4. Aladdin,
okay.
Lion King, Toy Story 4.
Okay, we're comparing those three. Just wanted to be really clear.
Yeah, what did you think, Señorita Valerie, of Aladdin, the live action versus the cartoon?
So I love Aladdin, the original cartoon.
Robin Williams.
Yes.
Hashtag rip.
That was one of my favorite movies as a kid.
Oh, it's still to this day one of the best movies that ever.
I thought you didn't like Aladdin as much.
So soon.
The fucking movie was fucking horrible.
Okay. So disappointed, honestly, in the live action. And at first, it looked beautiful. So they did do a good job.
Visually,
the scenery,
yeah. Visually, it was
it's
great.
It's really gorgeous. They changed way too much of it.
Yeah.
I am sorry. Like,
yeah, just a damn shame. It really was. I say this all joking aside.
It was painful to watch. And to, like, get through, you're like.
Yeah. Not only, I mean, again, I don't mean any disrespect to the actors or the actresses. I don't have a clue who you are, but you can't act and you can't do. You cannot give us what we had in the cartoon.
Well, and I honestly think whoever directed it, I'm sorry, it's on you. Because
no, it's 100%,
you changed,
yeah.
Like, the songs. Like, there was new songs. There was new lyrics to stuff. There was, like, all this funky, like, why?
And my favorite thing was in the movie.
We don't need
political
that.
Agenda.
Where?
The songs. The female thing. I'm like, oh my god. Have you been to the real India?
Well, I don't think it's bad to be like female empowerment, but do that in another movie.
Seriously.
Like, save that for a different movie. Aladdin is not the time. It's not the time.
No, and I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm gonna butcher this because I've obviously spoken about this before in previous videos. Will Smith sucks as the genie. He is fucking god awful. I can think of at least three people that would have been better genies. Vince Vaughn. You know, you could have even put like Owen Wilson.
Oh,
as
wow.
The genie.
What?
Yeah, because that's how bad Will Smith was.
I mean, after Robin Williams.
You just can't compare.
Man.
It's Robin Williams. You cannot reproduce what he brought
here
to Aladdin.
Again, I have to say, they tried like to add funny things and like Will Smith was like kind of the cool genie like this. Like he preserved, like there was some that was preserved, but a lot
like
of like
of
added stuff and you're just like, you know, no, like I'm sorry, but that was a big disappointment.
Yeah, it was terrible. So
it was one of those where you like have to keep watching it because you're like, I have to just get through.
It's a car wreck. You just gotta keep watching.
But why? Like, oh god.
Yeah, and the Jafar. I mean,
oh god, I forgot. He was a joke.
It's a joke. I mean, literally.
Oh my god, this guy's supposed to be the bad guy. Like
nobody knew he was a bad guy. It's like, oh, that's Jafar. It kind of just looks like a random extra.
And his voice. I'm Jafar.
Seriously, dude, you went through puberty yet? Come on, son.
You're supposed to be this, like, dark character, this, like, evil.
And you were nothing but pathetic.
Yeah, I know, I can't. The only thing that was really great was the cat.
So, winner of that film, what do you recommend?
Well, 110%.
Clearly, the
Disney.
Cartoon. The cartoon will always.
Yeah.
The live action.
Don't waste your life.
Don't waste your life. Don't
go
waste
spend
your
2 hours doing something way better.
Yeah, it's terrible.
You know, like
it's
playing with toys. Thing. Let's go. Okay.
All right, moving on to The Lion King. The cartoon versus the live action.
Oh.
This is extremely tough, but I am not joking you. I would probably slip it towards the live action film. Mainly because, for those of you that know me,
I love how you asked me the question and now you're answering it.
Mainly because if you know me, you know I have a very large background in wildlife. Wildlife conservation, I've worked with wildlife, it's my passion, it's what I used to do, it's my joy, and everything in between. And to take one of my childhood greatest, funnest love movies and turn it into a live action and do it well
sorry
was fantastic. like, to do it the way they did, damn. From the CGI to just the way they portrayed, you know, the heart, the gut-wrenching scene where Mufasa gets killed. It just didn't look cheap. Mm-hmm. It looked legit and it looked real. And I think that's what stole it for me.
I was so surprised. I mean, I was like, how did they do this film?
Bingo.
How did they make this look so real? And again, I think maybe this is like my age or whatever. You kept it the same, praise the
Seriously,
Lord.
Seriously, like, why is it so hard to keep it the same?
But okay, but we're talking about good things. Like,
no, that's what I'm saying.
Goodness.
As a good thing, why is it so hard to keep it the same as the film, as the cartoon?
It was
You didn't need to change it.
It was so wonderful that they did that with Lion King. It was literally like the music was the same. There was no new song. Like, they literally, the scenes, the Hakuna Matata scene was exactly, oh my gosh.
Even the little, like, there was little Timon, you know, he has those little quotes where I can't remember one right now, but they're just perfectly placed.
It's like, oh, you know? God, if you need a film, if you need a feel-good film and you just need to, like, go, like, remember, just remember your childhood.
That first scene, literally.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's penguins on my body.
Okay.
Oh my God, it's penguins on my body.
Yeah, who knows where he gets these lyrics.
But yeah, I would say, I mean, that's not to discredit the cartoon. The cartoon is obviously phenomenal. It is truly an amazing film.
Lion King, either way you go.
But the live action stole. Like, if you look at the last
music.
Yeah. Oh, if you look at all the live action films Disney's come out with so far, Lion King, number one. Lion King live action, if you have Disney Plus and you haven't watched it yet, go fucking watch it. Time to talk about potentially the last film in... Possibly the last film in the franchise, because...
Possibly Señorita Valerie's last film on Spotify.
Well, because here's it, because, like, Disney said, like, they were going to finish it at number 3, but they didn't, and they made a number 4. I'm not shocked, and I'm curious if they'll make a number 5. Regardless, though, Toy Story 4, here's our review on it.
Here's our
review. It was good, but it wasn't great. It's, to me, it was a little lackluster. I think the story was very forced. It was very kind of like, if you ask me, I think the CEO of Disney was just sitting in a boardroom one day and said, hey, can we make another $1 billion? Let's just make another Toy Story. Okay, cool. What do you want the story to be? I don't know. Make Woody get lost. Make a fork from the trash. Sound like a plan? Alright, cool.
Someone
go do
was
it.
Probably eating with their spork
yeah.
during that meeting yeah. and went, oh, Sporky.
The whole pretense of the film is the toys are now with a new kid, which I wept like a child when I watched the end of the third film.
You did?
When he gives away his toys to the little girl. So the toys are now with the new girl. The new girl makes this forky toy. This forky toy is like not right upstairs and disappears. And of course they have to go find him and that's where it goes. And it was just kind of dull.
Almost Aladdin-esque, but not as bad.
Yeah.
It's still kind of
like
a feel-good.
Like, it's watchable.
Like,
you,
it's a feel-good
watch
movie.
It once.
You might watch it once.
You might watch it once. Like, it definitely took, what, about 20, 30 minutes for it to really actually start to get going?
I actually thought the beginning was better than the end. And let me just say, those dolls are creepy
yeah.
as hell.
So the bad guys in the film.
So you pulled some creature that looks like the Saw doll. Literally. Yeah, and it's literally playing a game with like Sporky and like creepy.
Yeah, it just. And then here's the thing too. At the end of the film, the way it wraps up again, big spoiler, Woody walks away from the whole group. So he now is officially a lost toy because he's obviously not played with anymore and.
Well, he went to be with Bo Peep.
The story is just kind of like, wow, okay, so that's how you're going to wrap this franchise up, is splitting the group apart.
I think they left it in a question mark.
I think they ended this franchise in a big question.
Yeah, I think it was missing
like
a lot.
Why are you doing this?
It left a lot to be desired.
Yeah,
that's for sure. I mean, kind of just go like, okay, like I guess there's something next.
Yeah,
I don't think
because
the
1, 2, and 3 it builds off the fact that you know you have kids and kids love toys and they have innocence but they do eventually grow up. So these toys get passed on and yada yada. And then this fourth one is just so they're just trying to get the fork back to the girl. And then I guess we should just kind of part ways.
They'll come back together, I guarantee you.
Toy Story 5 in space.
Okay, 5. Okay, my favorite thing. My favorite thing in Toy Story is Little Bo Peep and her sheep. I think they are hilarious.
Pop quiz, what's their name?
Billy Goat Gruff.
Yep. Cool. If you enjoyed the Toy Story films, I think you will. If you have Disney Plus, watch it. If you're bored one night, don't expect a lot. Watch Lion King. really, that's pretty much the premise of this. But anyway, we're going to wrap this episode up. Thank you all so much for
watching.
We want
to know what you thought.
What did you think? Have you seen these films? Do you prefer the live action or do you prefer the cartoon? Tell us why. Don't forget to subscribe. For the love of God, I'd love you if you would subscribe to me. And stay tuned. Wait, what did he say?
He's a pole toy. Something about a pole
toy. Do it again. Exactly. That's what I say sometimes when I have to poop.
Oh my God.
Anyway, y'all, thank you so much for watching. We will see you next time. Later. Bye-bye. Oh God, I broke it.